Good morning, this is Joy from Enjoy Fitness 43, and this morning we're going to be doing a super tone workout. So you're going to need a mat, 2 weights, and something to drink. So get that stuff ready and we'll get working. Okay, talk to you in a minute. We're going to do a super tone workout. So we're going to just warm up first and just have our cup of weights and our water with us. And we're going to start with abs. We're going to see if we can't just get every part of the body done this morning. Abs, and then we're going to do arms. I think we're going to end with legs here. Okay, and then let's get that waistline. So rotate from side to side, that heel up. Good, now reach. See if you can reach down and then up. Just doing a wood chop. Other side, so reach up and then back down. And it's good to try to watch the hands when you do that, because then it helps the neck flow with movement. Okay, then we're going to hold it here and we're just going to squat. So feet are a little bit wider than shoulder width apart. We're just going to go up and down, trying to warm up the hips and the knees. Couple more here, and then we're going to go ahead and take a reverse lunge. So let's take a reverse lunge. So we're going to alternate sides. Good. Keep going. Do a few more on each side. Okay, now we're going to take a step out to the side. So we're going to just stay on this side. Let's do one more. And let's switch to the other side. One, then we're going to come up on the heel, what about toes, so the heels come up. And then we're just going to take our hands and we're just going to bend the knees slightly, and then we're going to slide our hands down, trying to have a nice flat back, and then come back up. So nice flat back, so you don't round the back and push the tush out. Warm up the glutes and hamstrings here. Okay, then one more. Okay, we're going to come back up and we're going to plant the feet. We're going to do a hip circle. So big hip circle. Goes all the way from the ankles up to the neck. It's rotation. And me, things are crack-a-lacking. And then we'll get those hands out. We'll just rotate those wrists around so we're holding some weights. And we're going to get down onto the mat here first thing and doing some plank moves. And shake out the hands. Alrighty, so let's get down and we're going to do, it's actually a 12-minute workout for our abs. So we'll be, I believe it's all on the floor of our ab moves. So we're going to start with mountain climbers. So just hands down. So if it's more comfortable for you to be on your elbows, you can be on your elbows during the mountain climbers. otherwise. We're going to do 45 seconds of mountain climbers, and then we are going to get onto our elbows, and we're going to do some hip touches, and then we're going to sit down and do some Russian twists, and then we're going to lay down and do some alternating leg lifts. I'm going to scooch down a little bit more. So here we go, and we're just going to do mountain climbers. So you can run it, or you can just bring your knees up, trying to keep those shoulders over the wrists while we're doing this, pulling the abs in, keeping the head up, don't drop your head down, trying to keep it up so it's in alignment with your spine, so you can feel that tummy be nice and taut while you're doing this. You don't have to run it out. Just pulling that knee up towards those arms is gonna make a huge difference with those abs. Being in this plank position works so many parts of the body. Okay, here we go. Okay, so now we're gonna go into a hip touch. So you're on your elbows, and we're gonna go into that plank position again, and we're just gonna roll the hips from side to side. It doesn't have to touch the floor. You know, we just think about it. We just roll the hips from side to side. Position those feet if you have to, because they kind of like to go out from under you a little bit as we roll it from side to side. This does a lot to your spine. So the first couple times you do this, you're like, wow, that's a really tough movement. And it's usually because you're not used to rolling your spine like this. So if you need to go to your knees, you can go to your knees, and you can do the same movement on your knees. Just try to make sure you have a nice flat back and your booty's not lifted up during it. Alrighty, so now we're gonna go ahead and get onto our tush. And if you'd like to grab a weight for this one, we're gonna hold onto a weight. And you can lift up your feet or you can keep them down on the floor, but I'd like you to have a nice flat back and not a rounded back. So we try to look up past the feet out in front of us, and we're just gonna drop the weight from side to side. Keeping the feet up, just a little bit more pressure, you know, on the abs, and it just keeps you bit taut, keeps those tummy muscles taut a little bit more, so you get just a little bit more of a workout. So we're just gonna hold it side to side. And then the next exercise, you can either use a weight or not. We're gonna go ahead and lay down, and you're gonna press the weight up over the chest, and you can lift the head or not. And we're just gonna alternate those legs, bringing them up and down. It's not super fast. And we wait till the other leg is there before we drop the alternating leg. So it's not a quick scissor type motion. It's just a staggered leg drop. And so if your neck starts to hurt, you just let it come back down, take a little rest. Otherwise, you try to keep it up. And instead of looking at your feet, you look straight up towards the ceiling. And then that way, it's a little bit gentler on your neck. And you're not cutting off your airway as we're trying to do this move. So you can either tap your heel on the floor or just bring it down to where it's comfortable. Okay, so we're going to set the weight down. We're going to do that mountain climber move again. So we're going to go through these exercises two more times. So get yourself ready for that mountain climber. Pull that belly up. I can pull that belly button in. You know, you try to get in control of those muscles below the belly button. Try to keep that head up. Don't drop it down. Trying to keep it in alignment with your spine is key, because it helps keep everything happy in your back, so you don't come out of here with a neck ache. So keep breathing during the exercise. Find a good steady flow for you. Inhaling, outhaling, outhaling, exhaling. That's funny. Okay, elbows. And remember, you can do this one on your knees or all the way out in that plank position. And we're going to just roll back and forth. Dropping those hips. Trying to get that waistline nice and tight. So we work the inner and outer obliques. And then we work on the upper and lower abs. And what's nice about planks too is you work that back too, because your abs are girdle. So try to work all the sides of that ab girdle to cinch in your waistline. All right, on the tush, doing that Russian twist. And people talk about, ooh, how planks can do everything for you. Well, they can make you have nice flat abs, but they also make you have nice flat sides too. So you gotta put those movements that have a little twisting in them that are the, you know, the ab, the plank hip drops, and things like Russian twists, and even side bends that help you get that little movement in your obliques so that you have your waistline pulled in a little bit more, because you want more of an hourglass figure than you do straight sides, because we don't all want to look like little boys. All right, so all the way down. Weight over the chest if you want it. Otherwise, you can put your hands to your side. Legs out, head up, looking at the ceiling. Okay, now switch those legs. Find a nice way to breathe. Make sure you're not holding your breath. Make sure that weight stays above your chest. That angle also helps make those upper abs just a little bit more taut. And then when you bring it over your face, you lose that angle that helps do that. And you also make it a little bit more dangerous for yourself. So you always want to be safety first here. All right, one more round. Almost done. So we're going to start with the mountain climbers. Okay, so think about your posture here, making sure that your shoulders are above your wrists and your neck is up and you're not dropping your head down, trying to look at your feet. Because when you do that, I mean, you can feel the difference. You drop your head and you pick it up. You can feel the difference in your tummy when you do that. Like I said, you don't have to run it out. You can if you want to. But you're gonna do this, the same movement. Okay, this for 45 seconds, it's a long time. Just try to pull that knee up as high as you can. That's your best bet. Making sure you're breathing. All right, coming down, get all the way down to those elbows. Decide if you want to be on your knees or all the way stretched out to that plank. Get yourself nice and comfy. Now I fold my hands, you can lay them flat, doesn't matter. Okay, legs out, drop them from side to side. Just rolling the hips. Again, taking your time with it. You don't have to do it super fast. You have to be in control of the movement the whole time. You need to take a knee or take both knees. You can switch it to that halfway through. Or you can take a little breather. and then come back up into it. Alrighty. On to our behind, getting ready for that Russian twist. Grab that weight. Heels up or down. Nice flat back. And just dive behind that weight from side to side. Almost there. Start to feel that workout. All right, last exercise. Weights over the chest, nice flat back. Getting those legs ready. Okay, drop one leg, bringing it up. So just a little split leg. Remember, you're looking at the ceiling. Weights over the chest. Kind of bouncing on that tailbone. So when you drop that leg, you gotta think about pressing down through that tailbone so you're not overarching your back. Your weights are like, your legs are weights that you're dropping down, pulling in your abs. So you're working those lower and upper abs here and the obliques all at the same time, which is by dropping a leg and holding a weight up. Alrighty, done with those. You're gonna get yourself a drink of water. Oh, we're gonna do legs next. All right, let me make sure I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, this is another 12-minute workout. So we're gonna do 2 rounds. Stand up for this one. So we're gonna go in between, maybe using, I think we're gonna do 2 weights for most of it. So we're gonna get those 2 weights ready. Alrighty, so we're going to start with just a deadlift. So feet are going to be about shoulder width apart. So you're going to bend your knees just a tiny bit as we do this. So we don't want real straight legs because we're going to end with, I'm going to move back just a little. We're going to end with a wide leg, straight leg deadlift at the very, very end. So, I put the break in the knee, so not like this. But just a tiny, so they're not pushed back all the way. We're gonna start with a nice deadlift. 45 seconds of work. So let's go ahead and grab the weight. And remember, they're gonna go push right against your skin all the way down your legs. And you're gonna look at the tiles out in front of you as they go by. And you don't ever look at your feet. And then you're gonna just come back up nice and tall, squeeze the buns. Straight down the front of your legs, just to the top of your feet. Come back up. So we never go out in front of our toes with our weights because we have dumbbells. Now, of course, if you had a big barbell, it would be different. But we don't. And we really are thinking about pushing that tush back because our weights aren't super heavy. We really got to think about pushing the tush back. Nice flat back. Neck's always in alignment with our spine. So by the time we're done, we're just looking out maybe, 3 tiles in front of us. Back up. Good. Alrighty, so we're going to do a single leg deadlift. So we're going to take the left leg and bring it back just a little bit, and the heel is going to be up. We're still going to use both weights, okay? And then we're going to go into a squat. So we're going to go down, we're going to come up, and we're going to go into a squat. Good. We're going to put that leg back. Good. Down to the deadlift. Take it over. Go to squat. Good. Take it back. Down to the deadlift. Go into a squat. So you have to be real single-minded with that deadlift. Nice and slow. our knee is slightly bent on that straight leg, just a little bit, just like it was on our first deadlift. And then we just have to make sure we place that foot out for our nice squat, and then put it back where it belongs for our next deadlift. Oh, all done, so much talking. Okay, so we're gonna do a tipping bird. So we're gonna put the weight down. So this is gonna be our solid leg. So we're gonna do a tipping bird, you know, which is here. And then we're gonna go tipping bird, and we're gonna drive this knee up. Tipping bird, drive this knee up. Tipping bird, drive this knee up. Tipping bird, drive this knee up. So it's not a long tipping bird, and you're supposed to be more graceful than I am. You're doing great. And then drive that knee up. That's it. Good, keep going. All right, so this next one is a squat swing, and it's not far, it's a shallow squat. So we're just gonna swing the weight and bend the knees a little bit, so we have to kind of get it going. So we just do just a little squat, a little swing, that's it. So it's just barely going down. Just take it back. Okay, working those quads there. Okay, so now we're gonna do a swing, but then we're gonna stop it, swing, and then we're gonna go into a reverse lunge. Swing, and we're gonna do the same leg, reverse lunge. So remember which leg you're doing, because then we're gonna do the other leg next time. Here we go, swing, reverse lunge. 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 Swing. Okay, good. Keep going, almost there. And then we have one more exercise after this. And then we'll start from the beginning. Okay, so our last one is, just have to touch that, a wide leg deadlift. So we're gonna get really wide legs. So straight, push the knees back, and we're gonna go down. It's gonna go down, and then come back up. So you have to think about pushing the tush back when you're doing it, coming back up, push the tush back. Nice flat back, good. And then when we're done with these, we're gonna bring those legs back in. We're gonna start all over again with that more narrow deadlift with a slightly bent knee. Okay, so we're gonna come all the way in, slightly bend the knee, and we're gonna do right up against the leg, sliding down, doing our deadlift. Okay, here we go. Stick the tush out, nice flat back. Come back up, give it a squeeze at the top. Sliding down, come back up. Squeeze at the top, good. Sliding down, good. Now our next one, remember, we're gonna do the single leg deadlift with, so You have to make sure you put the other leg back this time. And it has that squat in it. Squat. Almost there. Feel it in the tush today. Okay, so we're gonna just bring the heel up on the other leg. Okay? And then we're gonna take that leg out for that squat when we're after our deadlift, single leg deadlift. Breathe in. Okay, so we go down, come up, and and we do a squat. It's like I forgot the mechanics of this. We go down, come up, and we just go into a squat. Good. You don't even have to move your arms. If you want to, you can, of course, bring them up into a clean, but we're gonna do arms next. I'm gonna save my arms for that. Down. And squat. Okay, after this, we're gonna do that tipping bird. Just keep going. I'm gonna touch my phone. There we go. Squat. Down. Keep that heel up when you go down for that single leg deadlift. All right, so put the weights down. So, opposite leg you're going to be balancing on. Tipping bird with the knee up. Okay, so tipping bird, knee up. Good. You know, I was thinking, I let myself think, oh look, you're doing real good. And then I fall over. Just gotta think about balancing. Using the entire bottom of your foot. I have a tendency to want to use the outside of my foot too much. And then I try to compensate and use the inside of my foot too much. I'm sure there's a happy middle. Now it should be easy. All right, so swing squats. So it's just the little swing with a little bend in the knees. Of course, you can make them deeper if you want to. Here we go. And then our one after this will be the swing squat with the reverse one, opposite leg. So we're going to swing and reverse lunge. Almost there. Okay, so swing, then reverse lunge. Swing, reverse lunge. Right, so wide deadlift is the last one. Nice wide legs, straight legs. And we're just gonna go down. Here we go. All the way up. Give that those buns a little squeeze at the top. Nice flat back. Going down, placing those weights by the heels, or in between the heels, when you come down, so that you know that you're not bringing them out too far, trying to protect that lower back. Good. Almost there. Ooh. Okay. That's that. Okay, can I take a little rest, shake out those hands, and we're gonna do our last workout, just arms. Change my timer. Our last workout. Alrighty, so we're going to alternate pretty much in between weights. So we're just going to pick up one weight for the first one. Okay, so we're going to stick the other arm out. We're just going to do a single arm overhead press. Lift them here. So I'm just going to pull it up, balance us a little bit, bend those knees a little bit, make sure there's blood flowing. Okay, single arm overhead press. That's it. Get that arm up there. So 45 seconds is a really long time, especially when doing overhead presses. So we're getting probably, you know, three sets in on one arm in one round. So if you need to take a rest in between because your arm's going, yeah, I don't like this, you can do that. Typically, you probably do 8 reps, take a rest. Okay. Let's just go ahead and do the other side. I'm tired. Yeah, it's 28 reps. Okay, so we're gonna take that one weight, we're gonna bring it up, and we're gonna bring it behind our head, and we're gonna do tricep extensions. Try to bring those elbows in, and bring it up and down. That was 25. Okay, so we're gonna get on the floor. Okay, and we're gonna do a chest press with the chest fly. So we're gonna do a tricep chest press so that it's close to us. Chest press, chest fly. Back down. Chest press, chest fly. So depending on how heavy your weights are, you know, your arms will either go all the way down where your weights can get to the floor, or it'll just be the back of the upper part of the arm to the elbow. So just go with what you have. Just try to make sure that your chin isn't tucked in or overextended, because you just want to be able to breathe and look at the ceiling. Make sure that weight stay in the chest area and not linger above the head. Woo, good. Okay, so you're gonna take one weight, okay, and you're gonna hold it, and we're gonna go cross body. We're gonna go from the left shoulder up or from the right shoulder up. So it's gonna go across the body and then up. So, because my arms are like, woo, you're tired. I'm gonna hold onto my bicep with the other arm so that I don't conk myself or anything. Because my arms are saying, you shouldn't have left the arm workout for the last thing. That was crazy, Joy. These weights are feeling heavy today. All right, and we're gonna do the other side now. At the shoulder, so just a cross body tricep extension. Okay, up we go. All right, so we're gonna stand up. Oops, get over my water. And we're gonna just put your hand on your left knee and the weight in your right arm. And we're gonna do a one-arm row. So one-arm row. Elbow back as far as you can. Switch arms to the other side. Just a rest in here. Okay, one arm row. So you're gonna grab both weights. Okay, and we're gonna do cross body bicep curls. So we'll bring them over here. And we're just gonna take them across from left to right. So up one. weights out to the side in a nice little fly. So nice flat back, bent knees, bent at the hips. Next in alignment with the spine. Okay, bring them out. That's it. Okay, time to stretch. First I'll shake it out, yeah. No kidding.
I thought we were gonna do it again.
No, 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 one time. That was it. All those different things. Getting all the different major muscle groups of the upper body. Up and over. I can't believe how tired my arms were today with that. I guess because I usually do arms first and legs last, or abs last, one or the other. Wow. Okay, bring it over. So slide the hands down to the top of the knees, stick the tush out, nice flat back. And then take the hands all the way down, round the back, pull in the belly button. Take deep breath in, and then blow it out and just slowly roll up. Hands up over the head. Okay, cross the right leg over left leg or the other way around. And then we're just gonna do a little side bend. And then I go ahead and do it the other way. And then we're gonna come up and switch the legs. Okay, do a little side bend. Arms behind you, chin to chest up. Shake those arms out. Shake the legs out. Okay, a couple of breaths in. Deep breath in. And exhale. Again. And exhale. One more time. We're all done. Yay, have a good day.